G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, I just want to go through the process of working out the height to put in our door head when we're building a wall frame. So obviously in this opening, we've got to fit our door, our jamb. We've got to have a little bit of a clearance over the top of the door, just so that if a load came onto this head, it wouldn't bow and touch the top of the door. And we've got to allow a little bit under the door for our carpet. So let's have a look at the side of the door. So obviously the biggest dimension we're gonna have to worry about is our door itself. Standard door 2 meters and 40, 2040. However, nowadays you can get them just about any height you like, and if you're doing like renovations or you're using secondhand doors, maybe worth checking the actual size of the door. So first dimension you need to include is the actual height of the door. Then above the door, we've got to consider a few things. So the clearance between the door and our jamb, 3 mil usually if you're going to paint the door and the jamb, or if you're only going to use a clear coat, around 2 mil. We also have to consider the thickness of our jamb material. So I've got 15 mil in this case, but it could be 18 mil, fairly common. And then above the door, the timber framing code actually says we have to have 15 mil clearance between our top of our door jamb and the head, especially in a load bearing wall. Okay, so we just generally lay our 15 mil above the door as well. So that's everything up there. If we go down to the bottom of the door, so the door finishes here, and we actually want the jamb to continue and sit right down on whatever our floor surface was. So whether it's a concrete slab or our particle board flooring. And then of course, on top of that, you're gonna have your carpet or your floating floor, whatever the case may be. So you have to have a bit of an allowance for that, just so you're not cutting the bottom of the door off. So in this case, I'm gonna allow 25 mil underneath there for that. So with all those added up, we actually end up with a door height or an opening height of around 2 meters and 98. So yeah, very close to 2.1 meters, which is fairly standard. Just the thing to watch, if you're not going to have much of a floor covering, like just vinyl or something, then you may, you're going to have to take about 20 mil off this. The biggest problem is if this head's too low, then your architrave may not cover the opening. So you want to make sure that head is reasonably close. So 2.1, for about an inch or 25 mil of floor covering, 2.1 is a fairly standard opening size. If you're not going to have any or much under your door, then you might have to go to say 2 meters and 80 as your opening size. But that'll give you the height that you need to put in your door head in a timber frame. So that's from the underside of the plate to the underside of that door head or door trimmer in your frame.
G'day again, I'm back. Just to let you know, if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.